لا أقسم بيوم القيامة. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes an oath and vows by the severity of the day of resurrection. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made this the promised day. The day that no one can escape. The day where all of us shall stand before Allah, exposed, open for critique, knowing of our own condition. كَفَى بِنَفْسِكَ الْيَوْمَ عَلَيْكَ حَسِيبًا. You and I, we will be enough of those who can account for our errors before our Maker. إِنَّ السَّمْعَ وَالْبَصَرَ وَالْفُؤَادِ كُلُّ أُولَٰئِكَ كَانَ عَنْهُ مَسْؤُولًا. Your hearing, your sight, and the intent, malice, and evil movements of the heart and pre-intentions of wronging others. All of that you shall be held accountable for. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala refers to the day of Qiyamah often in the Quran. In fact, there is a chapter that carries its name. Al-Qiyamah is the waking up, the standing up, the resurrection, the realignment of all of our dealings before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يَوْمَ تُبْلَى السَّرَائِرِ. The day where all secrets will become known. The day where all hidden things will become present. The day where all inequity shall be settled. The day where none shall be able to escape judgment, and no one has power or ability except that which is provided first to them by Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala discusses this day of regret. وَأَنذِرْهُمْ يَوْمَ الْحَسْرَةِ. Give warning to them, O Muhammad, of the day of severe regret. يَوْمَ يَعَضُّ الظَّالِمُ عَلَى يَدَيْهِ. Where a person will bite down upon their hand in fear. يَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِي اتَّبَعْتُ الرَّسُولَ. And they will say, I wish I had followed the messenger. يَا وَيْلَتَى. Oh, how wretched is my state. I wish I had not followed اتخذت فلالا خليلا, that I followed this person who I considered a best friend. لقد أضلني عن الذكر بعد إذ جاءني. They misguided me and took me away from the remembrance of God after it had arrived to me. وكان الشيطان للإنسان خذولا. And all devilish means and behaviors has brought mankind to its humiliation. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on that day of waking up, that day of resurrection, where the first to exit their grave will be Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and with him will be those who are of the righteous in their conduct. We ask Allah to rouse us from that slumber and sleep that was restful and comfortable. قَالُوا مَنْ بَعَثَنَا مِنْ مَرْقَدِنَا. They will say, who brought us out of our grave? هَذَا مَا وَعَدَ الرَّحْمَنِ. This was the promise of the merciful Lord Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That day where everyone shall stand in front of Allah. In the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, مَا مِنْكُمْ مِنْ أَحَدٍ. There is not a single one of you. إِلَّا وَسَيُكَلِّمُهُ اللَّهُ لَيْسَ بَيْنَهُ وَبَيْنَهُ تُرْجُمَانِ. There is none except that they will stand before Allah without barrier or translator. And Allah will speak to them and question them. فَيَنْظُرُ الْعَبْدُ أَيْمَنَ مِنْهُ. A person will look to the right. فَلَا يَرَى إِلَّا مَا قَدَّمْ. They will only see the deeds they brought forward from their life. وَيَنْظُرُ أَشْأَمَ مِنْ فَلَا يَرَى إِلَّا مَا قَدَّمْ. To the left, you only see the deeds that you have brought forward in your life. وَيَنْظُرُ بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ. And you will look before you on that day. فَلَا يَرَى إِلَّا النَّارَ. And in front of you is hellfire waiting for those who are deserving of it. فَاتَّقُوا النَّارَ وَلَوْ بِشَقِّ تَمْرَةٍ. Save yourself from the torment of that day, from that questioning, even if it is with half of a date. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَنْ نُوقِشَ الْحِسَابَ عُذِّبْ. The one whom Allah stops and questions will be punished. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala questions you about every aspect of your life, there is no escape of the punishment. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam warns us that the way to escape is to get the first question right. Because if the first question's right, everything soon after follows. After your tawheed, أول ما يسأل العبد عنه. After you're shown you're a believer in Allah, the first thing you will be questioned about, asked about by Allah, is your salah. In saluhat, in tammat, fa saluha al-amalu kullu. If your salah is complete, if your devotion was accepted, if you stood before Allah with humility, with piety, with regularity, with consistency, then on the day of standing, you will find it easy and an easy pass. It is not a coincidence that our salah begins with a standing before Allah, lined up in lines, facing the direction where Allah is presumed to accept our prayers, our sacrifices, and our nadr to Him. We stand in that alignment as the day we will stand on the Day of Judgment. Because if you stand and bow to Allah in this life, you will be able to stand and be given bowing to Allah on the Day of Judgment that will ease your path to Jannah. أَوَّلُ مَا يُسْأَلُ الْعَبْدُ عَنْهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ الصَّلَاةِ. The first question is your prayer. In صَلُحَتْ صَلُحَ الْعَمَلُ كُلُّ. If it's accepted, all of your deeds are accepted. Let Allah see you in qiyam and in ruku' and in sujood in this life so that you will have that ability to enter al-jannah بغير حساب on the day of qiyamah. Allahumma ameen.
Hope you enjoyed and benefited from the video. And I'd like to invite you to support al-Maghrib in these blessed last 10 nights of Ramadan so that we can create more content like this and further our mission to teach the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam Islam one student at a time. You can support at almaghrib.org/support.